Now I've been in Ireland for quite some time, so if I wanted to create a video telling you why you should study abroad in Ireland, I would have done that already. But I just came to realize that there's no such video on my channel. So I thought, let's do it. Now there's another reason why I'm creating this video. It is because in the next video, you will learn about why you should not move to Ireland. And that video will be a little critical. So I thought, why not, let's create this video as part one to that video and start this discussion on a positive note. Now I know there are lots of websites, videos and so many student services, agencies that have put up list of things about why you should study in Ireland. So obviously I'm not going to tell you all of those things, that I'm not going to paint a rosy picture, because that's not what I do, that's not who I am. I like to evaluate the facts and then critique them so that you have this little debate in your mind and you can make the most productive and most beneficial decision for yourself. Because we want, by we I mean you and me, we both want you to make the most of the opportunity and be successful in your life. But before we begin this discussion, let me tell you that I am not advising anyone on settling in Ireland. We are just talking about studying in Ireland, getting education. But then if you want to study just so that you can stay back and live in a foreign country, then that is not something that I endorse on this channel. And it has a lot of challenges associated with it that you will learn in the next video. But for this video, let us just focus on getting educated or getting a post-graduation in Ireland. Okay, so with that being said, let us begin. Now, the single most important factor that people research about while making a decision about studying abroad is the cost. And I think that is where Ireland scores over other countries. Now, I personally know people from Canada, Australia, the United States, and the UK as well. And I can assure you that the tuition fee in Ireland is less compared to all these countries. Now there might be other countries who offer cheaper courses, but then I don't think these are English speaking countries. For example, Germany, where you barely need to spend a dollar towards your tuition fee, but there are other costs. Anyway, that's not the point of discussion right now. Now I know for non-European people, especially people from Asia, Ireland is a very expensive country, but if you are living with a bunch of friends in a shared accommodation and sharing resources, then it's not that difficult. It's much more affordable, again, compared to the countries that I mentioned, countries like Canada, Australia, or the United States. So the cost of education, biggest plus point of studying in Ireland. Number two, National Framework of Qualifications, NFQ. Now, NFQ is a body that monitors the education standards in Irish universities and colleges. This guarantees high quality of education. Thumbs up to NFQ. Number three, the vast variety of courses that are being offered. There is something for every kind of academic interest. If you want to study about forestry or maybe alternative fuel, or you might even want to study about marine life, there is something for all academic interests. Now, I'm an Indian and I haven't seen any Indian going into these more exotic courses. They're more focused on getting a job, because this is how we have lived all our lives. Our parents have lived this way, and it is part of our upbringing that we have to get a job and get settled and all that. Life experience comes second to us. But again, this video is not about all that, so let's move on. Number four, the existing international community. There are lots of international students already in Ireland from all the countries. If you go to universities like UCD or Trinity College, you will find people from almost all parts of the globe that are studying in these universities. So rest assured that you will get that kind of international exposure if you choose Ireland to study. However, let me warn you here, there are certain colleges I don't think are up to the mark, but they are making the most of this business opportunity due to foreign students coming here. I don't want to name any colleges, but it's so bad that they're even offering courses which are absolutely useless just to make money. The reason is simple: international students pay almost twice the fee of that of the home-based students. Anyway, let's not drive away from the point number three, which was existing international community in Ireland. Cheers to it. Number four, 1 year's master's. Yeah, if you have ever typed on Google study in Ireland, then you already know that Ireland offers 1 year international master's course. I think this is the best part of studying in Ireland. Even the courses are very intense. Yes, it's only 1 hour, so everything will be rushed through. They'll finish their classes in 6 months, and then you'll have to do a lot of market research and then write a dissertation and all those things. It's quite hectic, but I like the fact that it's just 1 year, because it's almost like doing a job. It's important to learn that intensity, and it's important to be in that atmosphere. It bodes well for your future. Number five, youngest population in Europe. This does not apply to entire Ireland, but I want to focus on Dublin here, because after all, more than half of the population lives in Dublin. So Dublin has the youngest and the most dynamic population in the entire Europe. Yes, and that means only one thing: good times in the pubs. Not only that, the overall atmosphere in the city, especially during good sunny days and during holidays, it's really vibrant and wonderful. So cheers to that. Number six is the home of Guinness. If you don't know what Guinness is, when you get here, you'll surely be introduced to it. So don't worry about it. Just keep an open mind about it. Not just that, if you look at it in an overall sense about living in Ireland, be open to learning things, be open to meeting new people, be open to smile at people on the streets. Because a lot of times I see people just get here, especially South Indian students, they just come here and they're in a group of their own till the end of the course, which I think is absolute bullshit and an absolute waste of opportunities to interact with international people. Trust me, there's a lot to learn when you talk to people from different countries. Honestly, it's eye-opening. There's a lot to the world than to what you've seen until the time you decided to move abroad. Okay, number seven, or was it six? Well, last but not the least, LGBTQ tolerant country. Ireland is tolerant to LGBTQ people, so if you're one of those guys, don't worry, it's okay, you can be open in this country. From where I come, or from a lot of Asian countries, it is not something that people openly agree to. You don't have to worry about that either if you're one of those, and if you want to study in this country, you're really welcome. And why I'm telling about this point is because it is a state of mind of some people, and you have to accept them, because people are people. Anyway, so these are the points which I thought don't really have a lot of information about on the internet. So here it is. Hope you like the video. If you do, please give it a like, the thumbs up button right there. Subscribe to the channel, a red button next to it. And don't miss the next video, because it's a really critical discussion about why you should not choose Ireland. I think it'll be eye-opening for some people, and of course, it'll make me a villain. Anyway, the intention is not that. I just want you to, think critically about your life. Take care of yourself, guys. Bye-bye.